So welcome to the crystallography lecture 1. So today we will be discussing about the very starting topics of the crystallography and the projection part basically, and combination of lot of operators of the crystals, and along with that we will be learning about the projection of the operator itself. So before that, let's start with the basic knowledge about the crystal and what is the need of crystallography, and let's try to understand what is symmetry and what is the need of these projection and all in the crystallography. So if you go anywhere in the field, it is very common to see lot of crystals, because the hydrothermal fluids which flow through the cracks from any geological formation are basically very rich in some fluid mobile element. So these element crystallizes and we get a lot of good crystals. So the very common crystal is quartz crystal. I hope you all would have seen that. And these quartz crystal basically belong to hexagonal system and trigonal system. These two systems are kept together. So this is some implication we will be discussing later on. So the point here is to see the symmetry in the crystal. So you all would have seen cubic crystal of halite and hexagonal prism kind of crystal of quartz. So if you take those crystal in your hand, so you can see six faces in quartz and eight faces in cube. If you orient those crystal in such a way that you want to see the symmetry content in that crystal, then maybe lot of student would have done in their master's classes, or student who are in graduation will be doing this in third year, I hope. So if you try to see the symmetry in those crystals, you can find fourfold symmetry in cubic crystal. You can find threefold symmetry in cubic system. So the important point what I want to make here is the external habit, the external symmetry which we can see in crystal are basically manifestation of the internal arrangement of unit cell. So the assemblages of all symmetry which we can see in the crystal form, in well-developed crystal, suggest something about the internal arrangement of that crystal. So this is the basic funda behind the whole crystallographic projection and the symmetry study. Because in hand, we can pick some hand specimen, and we can talk about the whole crystal, whole symmetry content in that crystal, and then we can figure out what symmetry it belongs to, symmetry class it belongs to, and what crystallographic system it belongs to. Then why I'm discussing about all this? Because the faces present in well-developed crystals are basically a three-dimensional feature. So it is very tough to draw three-dimensional images in a two-dimensional paper or copy. So wherever we need some kind of projection in our society, in our day-to-day life, or in our study, we basically search for the options where we can cut down 1 degree of dimension. So for example, let's start with the basic concept of projection with an example. Let's suppose there is a stick of length L. This stick is present in two dimensions, in X and Y. If there is somebody who can only see at Y axis, somebody can only move on Y axis, he doesn't know what is x axis and he doesn't know about 2-dimension or 3-dimension, but he want to understand the presence of this 2-dimensional oriented object, then how are we going to put this arrangement on one axis? I mean, how this y guy can understand that the orientation is like this or this or this? So for this we can do a kind of projection. For this, just put light here. This light will create a shadow on y-axis. Now the person who is present in at y-axis can easily figure out what is the length, what is the angle at which this object is in real space, just depending on the length of the shadow. When it is like this, the length of the shadow is this one. If it is inclined like this, the length of the shadow will be this much only. And if it is inclined like this, the length of shadow will decrease again. So my point is, there is a cutting down of one dimension in this case by projecting the object on one axis. This is a kind of projection. We can the very simple example of projection. In the same way we used to do for the crystal. Before moving to crystal, I'd like to tell you about some type of projections, or very important type of projection, which is called conformal projection. So, as you all know, the basic funda of the projection is to reduce the dimension. So there could be a lot of ways to do that. But those projection in which the angular relation can be reproduced after the projection also, those kind of projection are called conformal projection. So the kind of projection we use in crystallography is a kind of conformal projection. This is also a kind of conformal projection, but there are a lot of other projection which are non-conformal. So let's start with the projection types which are used in crystallography, in which we will be focusing on conformal type of projection. So the first one is orthographic projection. The second one is mnemonic projection, and the third one is stereographic projection. So what is orthographic projection, what is mnemonic projection, what is stereographic projection? So among all these three, the most important type of projection is stereographic projection, which we will be discussing in detail. And this is the kind of projection which is used for understanding the crystallographic symmetry on 2-dimensional plane. So just a kind of introduction I am going to give about the orthographic and mnemonic stereo projection. So for any kind of projection crystallography, you will have to first of all imagine a sphere. So let's suppose this is the sphere, and this is the equatorial plane of the sphere. The equatorial plane divides the sphere in two equal half, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Now imagine any crystal . I hope you can imagine this system. So first of all, what you have to imagine is keep the center of whole crystal at the center of whole sphere. So this is the way you have to keep the crystal. And since we have not started discussing about the crystallographic axes, so I am not talking right now about the C-axis orientation. For now I am just telling about the projection. So later on we will be discussing what is real way of holding a sample for projection. But for now, just the concept of the projection we are discussing. So keep the crystal at the center of the sphere and the center of crystal together. Now imagine the perpendicular line on any of the face which you want to project. Let's suppose this is the face we want to project. Draw a perpendicular on this face from the center of sphere and extend it. It will cut somewhere to the sphere. So this point is basically intersection of the normal of the face which has to be projected and sphere. So it is. So now the common confusion is a term called pole. So in book Perkins, they say pole is basically this normal line. But there are a lot of other crystallographic book who says this point is basically pole, the intersection point. So I am also considering this intersection point as a pole. So I will be calling this intersection point as a pole, not this normal as a pole. So now this is the pole. Alright, so now the way this face can be projected are of three types. How? Consider a plane which touches the northern pole of the sphere. Alright. Now we can do three kind of projection. First, project this pole on this plane considering the light is coming from infinite. So project this pole from infinite to a plane which is tangent to the north pole of the sphere. This is a projection. This is the projection of this face on this plane, and this kind of projection is called orthographic projection. The second thing is you can project this point by extending the same line. So this is the mnemonic projection of this face. Okay. The third way is that first see in which hemisphere the pole is. So in this case, this pole is in the northern hemisphere. So project this pole from southern pole by drawing a line, and it cuts this horizontal plane at this position. This is the stereographic projection. Now you might be those who know how we plot by reading Perkins, you might be getting confused that how this can be stereographic projection. So you'll have to understand that if you want to project any face of the crystal, you can choose a plane parallel to equatorial plane of the sphere and put that plane anywhere. That will be considered as the projection. I mean to say, you can consider this plane as here also. You can consider this plane as here or here. You can put it anywhere. Alright? The way of the projection will be similar. And the nature or the characteristics of the projection will be similar wherever you put this plane. But this plane should be parallel to equatorial plane. So for convenience, we take this plane as equatorial plane because the faces whose pole lie on the northern hemisphere will be projected on primitive circle. But those, the points which lies in the southern hemisphere, if we plot those point with the help of stereographic projection, those points will be lying outside of the primitive circle, and this primitive circle is basically this equatorial plane and sphere intersection. So this will create a kind of confusion. So we what we do for stereographic projection is we bring down this equatorial plane to this projection plane to equatorial plane. Alright, so just do not get confused about all these three. We are specifically going to discuss about stereographic projection. Just try to understand what is orthographic and mnemonic projection. So orthographic is you are projecting the pole from with a parallel line which is coming from infinite, and mnemonic is just projecting that pole from the center of the sphere. Now what is stereographic projection? We are specifically going to discuss. Intersection of a whole sphere and a equatorial plane. So you can imagine if there is a sphere and you cut this sphere with a horizontal plane, the intersection will be circle, the great circle, right? The circle with the diameter equal to the diameter of sphere. So this is basically the same circle. In case of Earth also, we can say that if you just do an analogy, just see the analogy between this this sphere and globe, then this equatorial plane is very similar to the equator of our Earth. All right. So how to do stereographic projection of any face? If this is a face, I mean, see, this is whole sphere and this is equatorial plane and this is the center of sphere. The very similar condition is here. Consider your crystal is kept with its center, or the center of the crystal is concentric to the center of sphere, and both are kept, their center are kept together on each other. Alright, so for stereographic projection, what we have to do, draw a perpendicular on the face which you want to project, and this is the normal of the face. This will cut to the sphere at some point. This is called pole. Now if this point is in northern hemisphere, then join this point with the south pole. Meanwhile, it will cut the equatorial plane at some point. In the same way, if any face is lying in such a way that the perpendicular drawn on this face from the center cuts the sphere in the southern hemisphere, this is the P dash, I mean the pole of this face, and it lies in the southern hemisphere, then join this with the north pole, and again it will cut to the equatorial plane at some point. So this you have to imagine that this is the whole sphere, and you consider this as a face. Now this is the center of the sphere. Draw a perpendicular on the face, so it will extend or just extrapolate this line, and it will cut to the sphere at some point. And if this point is in the northern hemisphere, then draw this or just join this point with the southern pole, then it will cut to the equatorial plane at some point, and this point is basically the projection of this face. Okay, so after doing this whole projection, you have to see the equatorial plane from front. And how will it look like? So it will look like, so we are looking from here. So here is one point and here is another point. Why I did so? This is solid dot, it means the pole is in the northern hemisphere. Pole means the intersection of the normal of the face with the sphere is lying in the northern hemisphere. Then if you connect this point with the south pole, then it will intersect the equatorial plane at some point. This point is indicated by full dot. This is full dot, means solid dot. In the same way, if the pole lies in the southern hemisphere, the important thing is pole, not the face. Sometimes phase arrangement may be like this, that it is in northern hemisphere, but its pole will be plotted in southern hemisphere. We can see this. So if the pole is in southern hemisphere, then connect this pole with the northern pole, and this line will cut the equatorial plane at some point, and draw that point as a hollow dot, and this is the projection of this face. So these two faces will be projected like this. So these two are basically the projection of this two faces. Now the important thing about the crystal projection with the stereographic method is to hold the crystal in such a way that the C axis of the crystal will be parallel to the north south of the sphere. I mean the line joining north and south point should be parallel to the C axis of the crystal. This should be the way of holding the crystal. Then imagine a sphere around it and then start plotting the normal of each faces, and then start noting down where the old poles are lying, then connect those poles with the respective north or south pole, depending on if pole is in northern hemisphere, then connect with the south pole. If the pole is in southern hemisphere, connect with the north pole. While connecting these points, these all lines will intersect the equatorial plane, and all those intersection points of the equatorial plane and the line joining the pole and northern pole or pole and the southern pole will be the projection of the respective faces. And those points will be either solid dot or hollow dot, depending on if the pole is in northern hemisphere, then that point will be solid dot, and if the plane the pole is in southern hemisphere, then the projected point will be represented as hollow dot. Now why we are doing this? Because it is possible that two faces, if one face is here and another face is here in the same orientation, then its pole will lie here and this face pole will lie here. Now if you join this pole with northern north pole, it will cut at the same position where this face projection is present. In that case, if we will not give two different symbols, we will be getting confused. Alright, that is why we are giving two different symbols. If the pole is in northern hemisphere, give it a solid dot, and if it is in southern hemisphere, give it a hollow dot kind of symbol. So if two faces are present in the crystal in such a way that their stereographic projection is going to lie at the same point on equatorial plane, then also we will be able to identify which one is in which orientation. All right. Now, we can do a little bit of mathematics here, which I'm not going to discuss too much because that's a completely different lecture we are going to put for the mathematical approach in the crystallography. So just a small introduction, because this part is really interesting and a lot of numerical can be solved with this, and a lot of numerical can be even made with the help of those mathematics. That's just a simple concept I'm going to introduce. So you people might have noticed why I am drawing it this all as a dotted sphere, or this is as a dotted circle. This has actually a reason. If there is no symmetry along a plane, so in stereographic projection of crystal, you have to represent that plane with the dotted line, and if a symmetry is present along that plane, that will become a solid line. So do not make any projection like this. This is completely wrong, because this represents that along equatorial plane there is a mirror plane. So what I said is, if the equatorial plane, this plane is being represented as a solid circle, means the line is solid, then this means that along equatorial plane there is a mirror plane, there is some symmetry. So when we project some face of any crystal, we do not show all this stuff as a result. We only show this equatorial plane, I mean the circle lying along the equatorial plane. This is only represented as the stereogram of the crystal. This is called a stereogram. So this is basically the stereogram, and in stereogram, the circles, if the circle is solid, means there is a symmetry along the equatorial plane. So what I was about to tell you is, if P is the pole of any crystal, any face of the crystal, it means projected point will be here, and if this is pole, means this line is what, this is basically the normal of the face, means face is oriented like this. All right, so this is stereogram of this situation. Now the normal is making phi angle with the north-south line, the line joining north and south plane, and this is phi by 2 because of the theorem of the circle, that one this arc will make, if phi angle with the center, this will make phi by 2 angle at the perimeter, right? So, what is this distance? Actually, we can calculate this distance. How? The radius is r. So, this is going to be r tan pi by 2. Means, if we know any point being projected here, we can actually exactly tell what is the dip of the face which has been projected. Just measure this distance. So this distance is d, we can measure that. So d is r tan phi by 2, and this r is basically the radius of this stereogram itself, because this is the intersection of the sphere with the equatorial plane, and the intersection will be a circle, and the radius of that circle will be radius of the whole sphere. So this is going to be r, so we can calculate this r, and this is d. The tan phi by 2 is d by r. Now phi is 2 tan inverse d by r. So we can calculate the dip of the face, because we know the angle of the inclination of the normal. So if we know the normal inclination, we know this angle, we have to know this, I mean the dip angle. So we want to know this. So this is again, this is phi. So the same phi will be the dip of the face. Alright. So this is a kind of problem which can be asked in any examination. This is just a simple representation of what we can do with the stereograms. A lot of other calculation can be done. You can even calculate the Miller indices of all these points, and you can calculate the zone axis and all. So this is completely a different lecture I will be taking for the numerical trends in crystallography. So let's now focus on basically the stereogram of the crystal. So earlier I said one thing, that if a face is lying in the northern hemisphere and if a face is lying in the southern hemisphere, we commonly think that the normal drawn on the face will intersect the sphere in northern hemisphere if the face is in northern hemisphere, and if the face is in southern hemisphere, the normal drawn will intersect the hemisphere in southern hemisphere. But depending on the orientation of the face, the pole position can change. Means the face is in northern hemisphere, but its pole can be in southern hemisphere. How is it? I mean, how the crystal will look like if the situation is like this? So this is the center. If we draw any face like this, the normal will cut the sphere in northern hemisphere, means the pole is in northern hemisphere if the face is like this. But at the same in the same crystal, if you imagine the face like this in the northern hemisphere, so to draw a normal to this face, you will have to extend this and then draw a normal. This will extend to the southern hemisphere. It will cut in southern hemisphere. So the pole is lying in southern hemisphere. So if somebody asks what is the projection of these two points, then just draw a pole, blindly draw the pole, means blindly draw a normal to the face and see where the normal is cutting to the sphere. So this is going to be the pole of this face, and this is going to be the pole of this face. Now forget about the orientation of the face, just see where is the pole. So this pole is in northern hemisphere, join this with the south pole, the intersection will lie somewhere here with the equatorial plane, and the pole is in northern hemisphere, so this will be represented as a solid dot. Now the pole is in southern hemisphere, join this with the north pole, it will intersect somewhere here, and since the pole is in southern hemisphere, the projection will be represented as a hollow dot. Now see, the face is in northern hemisphere but its pole is in southern hemisphere, so the important thing is pole. You know, if you want to decide whether it is going to be solid dot or hollow dot. Alright, so the stereogram of this case will look like this. I do not know whether this exists in nature or not, but there could be solution like this. Now in crystal, as we know, the important thing is its symmetry, because there is a regular arrangement of one small unit cell, and if you repeat the unit cell in certain way which are fixed, then the whole structure is also fixed, and the symmetry, the outer from the external form, will show a special kind of symmetry, and that symmetry is going to tell about the crystal. Now this becomes very important to understand what is symmetry. Alright, so if you take a Rubik cube, so you have six faces. If you hold the Rubik cube in such a way that a line is passing through two faces, then four faces are related with one fourfold axis, because if you rotate the cube, one same face you can find at four position, and each are lying at 90 degree with each other. So for understanding the crystallography, the very important thing is to understand the symmetry, and to know symmetry, the important thing is symmetry operator. So let's see what all kind of symmetry operator exist. First class is rotational symmetry. So this used to be like one fold symmetry, two fold symmetry, three fold symmetry, four fold symmetry, and six fold symmetry. Alright, this is rotational symmetry. Then there is symmetry called mirror plane. Which is represented as M. Rotational symmetry, these symmetries are represented as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6. And one more type is roto inversion. So this is going to be four type. The third type is inversion symmetry. This is represented as bar one, and the roto inversion, when this inversion symmetry combines with these rotational symmetry, so bar 2, bar 3, bar 4 and bar 6. Alright, so these are basically kind of symmetry we get in any crystal. Now how to identify a crystal has one fold symmetry, two fold symmetry, three fold symmetry or four fold symmetry or six fold symmetry? Or if a crystal has four fold symmetry, then can we say that the crystal has two fold symmetry also? Or if crystal has 6-fold symmetry, can we say the crystal has 3-fold symmetry? So these all things are very important to understand. So let's start with the one fold symmetry. So everything has one fold symmetry. if it doesn't have Rocco inversion. So why I say this is, if you take any object, for example, just take this hard disk. So the texture on this face is very different than of this. Alright. So if we rotate this, we are maybe its structure is quite elevated and this is flat. So we are considering these two are very different thing. So if you take this in your hand and rotate it 360 degree, you are going to get the same face. Alright. So this has 1/4 symmetry. So 1/4 symmetry means minimum 360 degree of rotation. If minimum 360 degree of rotation is creating the same face, then it is called 1/4 symmetry. In the same way, 2/4 symmetry, if there is a face in any crystal and at 180 degree the same face is present, I mean if we are taking one object and we can see one face in that object or one feature in that object and minimum 180 degree rotation is creating or by minimum rotating 180 degree we can find the same arrangement, the same face, then it is 2/4 symmetry. See why I am saying minimum 180 degree, because if you have one arrangement, then after 360 degree rotation you will get the same face. So can we say that if 2/4 symmetry is there, then 1/4 is always present? See, that is why the definition is minimum rotation. If the minimum criteria is being fulfilled, then the system is going to have that symmetry. I mean, if there is 2/4 symmetry, then only 2/4 symmetry is there. Why to call 1/4 symmetry? Alright, because we are getting the same arrangement at 180 degree. So less than 360 degree, there is the same kind of arrangement, then the symmetry is 2/4 symmetry. In the same way, if same kind of face is present at 120 degrees rotation, I mean to say, if this is a face and this is the axis, if you rotate this, so if you rotate this 120 degree and I'm getting the same face here, then again rotate 120 degree, I'm getting another face, so 240 degree rotation, then again rotate 360 degree, we are getting the same face, the first face. Now should we again call this has 1/4 symmetry? No, because 120 degree is lesser than 360 degree and at 120 degree we are getting the same face. So the precedence order says that this has 3/4 symmetry. Alright, 1/4 only we can say if it doesn't have any other symmetry. So if it has some other symmetry, then it has that symmetry, not the 1/4 symmetry. Alright, so minimum 120 degree rotation is creating the same face, so it has 3/4 symmetry. In the same way, 4/4 symmetry. So there is one face, rotate 90 degree and we are getting another face here. And again rotate 190 degree, there is one face, then again rotate 90 degree, another face, then again rotate 90 degree. So 360 degree, the same face is in front of you. So after every 90 degree, we are getting the same face, the same arrangement. In this, here also we can say that after 180 degree rotation, we can get, if this face is here, this face is here, one face is here, and one face is here. And this is 4/4 symmetry. If you rotate it 90 degree, this face will come here, right? Again rotate 90 degree, the same face will come here. So to these faces and these faces, should we call these two faces related with 2/4 symmetry? No, because these all are similar and one can be replaced just by 90 degree rotation. So minimum degree of rotation is 90 degree. So you can recreate the same face at 90 degree rotation. So the precedence order says that the system has 4/4 symmetry, because 360 by 4, I mean 90 degree, at each 90 degree you can create the same face. So the system has 4/4 symmetry, not 2/4 symmetry. Similarly, 6/4 symmetry, 360 by 6. So this is going to be 60 degree. So after each 60 degree rotation, you will get the same face. Alright. In the same way, here you cannot say that 6/4 has 3/4 symmetry, because in 3/4 symmetry, after 120 degree rotation only, you will be getting the same orientation or same face. But in 6/4 symmetry, after each 60 degree rotation, you are going to get the same arrangement, the same face. So the minimum angle is 60 degree to recreate the same object. It means if you take one face and you know that there is one axis which has 6-fold symmetry and I am telling you that this is one face, then you can create all other faces by operating 6-fold symmetry on one face, right? So this is why the symmetry is called operator, right? The symmetry operator, because it can work as an operator. See, this is one 6-fold and this is one face. Now rotate 60 degree and paste the same face, rotate 60 degree, paste the same face, rotate 60 degree, rotate 60 degree, rotate 60 degree. Six times you do this, you will be again coming to the same face, then stop your whole rotation. Alright, so when you apply any operator, symmetry operator, to create the whole object, so keep on operating the operator until you reach the same face. This is very important point, note down this. Alright, that you have to operate the operator until you reach to the same face. And this is how you are going to decide that a 360 degree rotation for this operator is enough to create the whole faces, or a 720 degree or more than that. Because usually we know these kind of operator can create in 360 degree, or in 360 degree all these operator can reach to the same face. But there are some operator in roto inversion which do not complete its full cycle in 360 degree. So how do I identify that? That is why I am saying that if you take one operator and operate that operator on one face, then keep operating until you reach to the same face. Alright, if there is 2-fold symmetry along this, then take this as one face given to you. Now somebody asks you to operate this 2-fold to create the form this system will have. Alright, means a 2-fold symmetry containing object, how would this look like? You have one 2-fold and one face. Now rotate 180 degree and paste it here, and again rotate 120 degree and paste it here. You are at the same position. Now the operation is complete. Now the shape which you have built is the shape this object will have. Means if something has 2-fold symmetry, then it will look like this. Similarly, if somebody asks you that if some object has 3-fold symmetry along this line and one of the face is like this, then how the object will look? Then what you will do, rotate it 120 degree and paste it, rotate 120 degree and paste it, rotate 120 degree and paste it. If you are reaching at the same plane from where you had started, it means the operation is now complete, and now the look, the shape you have generated is basically the shape the system will have. It has that symmetry. So this was the way rotational symmetry work. Now mirror plane. Mirror plane is very simple. If there is one plane, just put a mirror here, you will get another plane. So this is a mirror plane symmetry between these two. And what is 2-fold symmetry? If you rotate it here, this here. So for 2-fold symmetry, it is like, I think, see, maybe this will go like this. So this, no, the 2-fold symmetry is like this. So it is like this, and this is here. Alright, so this is 2-fold symmetry. So in hand, if you are doing like this, then it will become inversion symmetry. This I will tell you how it is inversion symmetry. So this is mirror plane actually, between two hands. So this is how mirror plane works. Now what is inversion symmetry and how roto inversion looks like? So inversion means keep a convex lens at the center of the crystal. Means if one face is here, put a convex lens here. And what will be the image of this face is basically telling you how the inversion symmetry look like. So if any face is there and you can find one other face somewhere in the crystal, and these two faces are basically image of each other, if we replace the center by convex lens, then the system is going to have an inversion symmetry. Alright, so rotating wedge like 2, 4, 3, 4, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar or bar 6, or you can call it bar 2, bar 3, bar 4, bar 6, this is how you pronounce this operator. So this was all about the symmetry operators. Now the important thing is, how do we represent these operators in stereographic projection or in a stereogram? If we plot the faces, then how are we going to identify by looking at the projection which kind of symmetry is present? Because I said earlier that conformal projection is something which can reproduce the angular relation of the reality, right? So in stereographic projection, we can see the angular relation of the faces, and that is why stereographic projection of the crystal retains the symmetry even after projecting the faces. Means the points which we are projecting will show the same symmetry what we can see in reality. Alright, so stereographic projection, which is a conformal projection, so we are going to see how the symmetry operator can be identified by looking at the arrangement of the faces in form of the stereographic projection. Or in opposite way, we are going to see if one face is given to you and the orientation of the symmetry operator of any crystal, then with the help of stereographic projection, can you draw the orientation of all faces, how the whole shape will look like, and what will be the stereographic projection of the resultant crystal. So let's start with the symmetry operator, like rotational symmetry. So we will start with twofold. So what we are going to see is, we are going to imagine the position of the rotational symmetry with respect to crystallographic axis, and then we will show those positions or the directions in the stereogram and the associated faces with that symmetry. It means, as we know, if any crystal has twofold symmetry, then it is for sure that there should be two faces which are related with that twofold. I mean, if this is twofold, then there should be one face here and another face will be here, right? So it will go like this. So this twofold has itself position, this itself has a orientation with respect to the crystallographic axis in the crystal. It means, if some crystal belongs to cubic system, then if it has four-fold symmetry, then it is easy to say that all these four-fold axes are along the A1, A2 and A3. Similarly, if any monoclinic system has two-fold symmetry, then we can say that this two-fold is along the B axis. So this is very important to know, that what is the orientation of that symmetry with respect to the crystallographic axis. Okay, so later on we will be discussing about individual crystal system and the relation of the symmetry contained in that crystal with respect to crystallographic axis. But for now, what I will tell you is that in whole crystallography, in whole point groups, or in all the crystals which exist in nature, what are all orientations which has been reported. It means, it is not possible to get four-fold symmetry in hexagonal system, in trigonal system. So when we are trying to understand the position of symmetry content with respect to crystallographic axis. This is very important to know that if you are dealing with crystal, do not create any kind of combination or permutation. The things are quite fixed. So if you go in hexagonal system, then it is for sure that along C axis there will be threefold or sixfold symmetry. All right. So let's start with the twofold symmetry. So there could be two possibilities or three possibilities if you are discussing about twofold symmetry. I mean, in case of monoclinic system, the twofold will lie along B axis. And as we have discussed earlier, that if you want to make crystallographic projection of any crystal, you have to hold that crystal in such a way that the C axis of the crystal should be parallel to the north-south direction of the stereo this sphere. Alright, so if this is the sphere, then you have to imagine the crystal in such a way that C axis lie like this. So in that case, in case of monoclinic system, if you discuss about twofold, it will be along B axis. Okay, and B axis is at 90 degree to A and C. Okay, so if this is C axis, then B will lie somewhere in this circle, the equatorial circle. So it will be like this or somewhere like this. It means this twofold is lying in the equatorial plane. Okay, so this is the symbol of twofold. This you make a lens type of structure and join this with a dashed line. So make it dashed, because in stereographic projection, anywhere if you are drawing solid line, that means there belong a mirror plane. Okay, so if there is no mirror plane, then simply you draw like this. This is the representation of twofold. But this twofold is oriented in equatorial plane. It means perpendicular to B axis. But there are several cases in which this twofold can exist along C axis. This twofold can be like this. For example, orthorhombic system. Okay, so in orthorhombic system, there used to be a lot of crystal which shows twofold along C axis, A axis and B axis, all three together. Okay, and along the axis. So there are two possibilities, that twofold may exist along C axis, or twofold in crystal will be perpendicular to C axis. If it is along C axis, then you will be drawing like this one, not this one. And if it is perpendicular to C axis, means this twofold will lie in the equatorial plane. It is like it is here. Right, and in the stereogram we used to see this equatorial plane from front, means if this is the sphere and this is your equatorial plane and the greater circle is like this, in stereogram we used to see like this. So if C axis is here, we will represent it on the plane in the center. Okay, so these are two possibilities or two orientation in which two axis can a two fold symmetry can exist. So let's see how the projection is done in these two conditions. This is our stereogram. So if twofold is represented at center, what does this mean? This means this is the sphere and twofold is lying along C axis, because we are looking at the stereogram, means the equatorial circle, the intersection of equatorial plane and the sphere, we are looking at that. Okay, in this direction. So this is C axis basically. Okay, so if something is twofold is represented here, it means that twofold is along C axis. Now if I say here is twofold, then where are those two planes which are related with the twofold? So if you take any point,
take any point, this point represents a face. As we know that if in a stereographic projection you if there is a face, then draw a bone. Alright, so this is going to be the projection of this face. In the same way, this point is indicating a face, and we can think what is the dip of this face if the projection is like this. We know this distance is what this distance is r tan phi by 2. So this is approaching to r, means if the face is lying at the perimeter, the distance will become r. So tan phi by 2 will become 1 and phi will become 90 degrees. Alright, so if any point is lying at the perimeter, it means the face it is indicating is vertical. Okay, and if it is here, then the face will be horizontal. Okay, now if this is one face, then due to twofold there will be one more face. Otherwise, there will not be any twofold symmetry. So where will be that face? So consider this is twofold, and here is one face. Now rotate it 180 degree. So this face will come here. In the northern hemisphere itself, it will rotate. Okay. So if it is solid dot, means it is a face in northern hemisphere, or it is a face whose pole lies in northern hemisphere. And now rotate it 180 degree, so it will rotate along a circle, and at 180 degree it will come here in the northern hemisphere itself. So this is actually stereogram of two-fold symmetry. Represent, if somebody asks you to make the stereogram of two-fold, if two-fold is along C-axis, then do this. Let's make a C-axis, make two-fold along C-axis, and this is one face, then rotate 180 degree and paste it here, and again rotate 180 degree, and if you are reaching at the same position, then the operation is completed. As I told you earlier, that until you reach to the same face, the operation is not complete. Okay, so this is representation of twofold. If it is along C axis, then this is the stereogram. Okay, so just you have to take one face and rotate 180 degree, paste it. Again, now both of them are solid dot if it is C-axis. But another case, is like this: twofold lies perpendicular to C-axis. Means if you take one face here, so this is twofold and here is one face. Now rotate it 180 degrees. So from northern hemisphere, this will go to the southern hemisphere. Okay. Similarly, so this is twofold, this is one face. Rotate it 180 degrees, this will move and go here. It's the same distance from this one in the other side, but a hollow dot, because this has gone to the opposite side of the sphere. Okay, so this is the projection. This is how you will do for twofold if it is along equatorial plane. Now let's move with threefold. So the interesting thing is threefold doesn't lie in equatorial plane in any of the crystal system. Either it lies along the diagonal of Q or it lies along C-axis. So we are only going to discuss about the C-axis part. The cubic part can also be discussed, but let's keep it for later. So if threefold is along C-axis, then this is the representation of threefold. Similarly, here is the threefold, here is one face. So the face is in northern hemisphere. So let's take one point which represents our face. Okay. Now you rotate it 120 degrees. So since it is threefold, so what is the symmetry operation? 360 upon 3 is 120. So 120 degree rotation. So here is one face, rotate 120 degree. Then there should be one more face. Or if you are taking one face, then just copy and paste it here, then again paste it here, then again you reach to the same position. So the projection will be like this. 120 degree, paste. 120 degree, paste. 120 degree, copy. So this is basically the geographic projection of three-fold symmetry if it is it lies along C-axis, and orientation of three-fold is mostly along C-axis. So this is the stereogram of three-fold symmetry, or you can say how three-fold operator works. It is like this. Now similar thing happened with the four-fold. Means four-fold only exists along C-axis. So we do not have to worry if four-fold exists along ketogen plane, because there is no such case. Okay. So while making the stereogram, just try to hear about few points, that when you are taking one face for starting your operator, just for your convenience, draw these four lines and take one point just before the line. Because if you will take it here, then very often when we will be discussing about the combination of the operator, a lot of symmetry will not be able to see. So just take few angles before the reference axis. Okay. So now rotate 90 degree, because it is 4-fold. So in 4-fold, 360 by 4 means 90 degree operation. Okay. So it will come just before this, and then again here. So this is the 4-fold symmetry. Okay. Similarly, we can do for 6-fold symmetry. Then 60 degree, then 120 degree, okay. Then here, so after every 60 degree you copy and paste it, and again you will reach to this one, because 60 degree, then 120 degree, 180 degree, okay, 240 degree, 300 degree, 360 degree. So in full rotation you are reaching at the same point. So the operation is complete, and this is how 6-fold will look like. This geogram of this geographic projection of 6-fold. Now let's discuss about the mirror plane. How mirror plane works. So again, mirror plane, see this. Till now we have seen rotational axes, so these operators are basically one line. But in case of mirror plane, the symmetry operator is a plane. Okay. So in previous cases, the axis could be at some angle with the C axis. That's how we say. But in case of mirror plane, we will have to say either it is along equatorial plane, or it is containing C axis. Okay. So if it is along equatorial plane, means it is perpendicular to C axis. It means this dotted line will become solid one. So until a mirror plane exists along equatorial plane, you don't have to make stereogram solid line. So if a mirror plane exists parallel to equatorial plane, then only this stereogram will look like this. In that case, if you take any face, for example, this is one face and this is mirror plane, the same face will be in the southern hemisphere, just below that. Okay. the stereogram will look like this. If mirror plane is along the equatorial plane, then just below that face there will be one more face, and since that will be in southern hemisphere, so that will be represented as a hollow dot, and this is called bullseye. So this is basically when mirror plane is along equatorial plane. But there could be some cases where mirror plane will be containing C axis. For example, this is one mirror plane. This is another mirror plane. This is how you will represent the mirror plane in stereogram, a full solid light. So let's see how the operator works. If this is mirror plane and here is one face, means this is mirror plane and here is one face, the other face will exist in this side, right? Okay, so where we have seen like this in twofold, we have seen the same thing. If twofold is along this, then at the equal distance there will be two faces, but in twofold there was a hollow dot. If in this side there is solid dot, because we are changing the sphere. Okay, in twofold you will change the sphere from here to here, but in mirror plane, if it is here, then again just in the northern hemisphere the same distance. But in twofold, if here is twofold, then one face will go in the different hemisphere. But with mirror plane it is like this. Okay, so two faces in northern hemisphere, and in twofold two faces in opposite hemisphere, but distance with respect to the symmetry operator will be same. This is how you will draw. Rotation and then inversion. So that is how this operator works. Means if it is 1 bar, then first rotation is 360 by 1, so 360 degree rotate. So rotate this object 360 degree. It will come to the same position. Okay? And then invert. So for inversion, go just opposite. Okay, diametrically opposite and in opposite hemisphere. This is bar 1 or I. This is how bar 1 will look like. Rotate and then invert. But see, in 360 degree rotation, we are not at the same point. So operation is not complete till now. You will have to rotate it again, 360 degree and then invert. Then you will reach to the same position. So I has 720 degree rotation to complete its full operation. Okay. As we have seen in 4, it is 360 degree rotation. In 2 again 360 degree rotation. But in case of I, there is inverted center, you have to rotate 720 degree, then you will reach to the same point. And you will, while creating the stereogram of any operator, you have to keep on operating the operator until you reach to the same position. As we discussed earlier, that if there is fourfold symmetry, then rotate it until you reach to the same face from where you had started. So this is how it is applied. Now how bar 2 will look like? Bar 2. So rotation is twofold, means 180 degree rotate and then invert. Okay, so if you take one face here, 180 degree rotation and then inversion, so solid will come to here as solid. When two fold will be operating, then inversion will create a diametrically opposite but opposite hemisphere. So here is the hollow. Again we are not at the same face, the position is same but the location is in different hemisphere. Then you will have to rotate it again in the same direction. You have to keep on rotating in the same direction. So 180 degree here as a hollow, then again here as a solid. This is bar 2, okay, and this bar 2 is very similar to a mirror plane. If you insert a mirror plane along, just if I say a mirror plane is along equatorial plane, then the stereogram will be like this. It is very similar to bar 2. If bar 2 is along C axis, then it is equivalent to the mirror plane perpendicular to C axis, okay. So very often we say bar 2 is equivalent to mirror plane. Wherever there is bar 2, you can say that there is mirror plane also. So these are similar operator. Now bar 3. So how bar 2 is represented? Bar 2 is represented as center mein ek hollow hoga. Bar 2 representation. Now bar 3 representation. 3 is represented like this and bar 3 will be represented like this. Okay. This is bar 3. So in bar 3 it is 3 fold rotation then inversion center. Okay. So 3 fold rotation will create what? This is one face. 120 degree rotation, you will come, this is for reference, just for reference. So this is one face, 120 degree rotation, you will come here with solid dot, then invert, you will come here as a hollow dot. Okay. Now 120 degree rotation as a hollow dot, you will come here, then invert, solid dot. 120 degree rotation here as a solid, but inversion will lead you as a hollow. 360 degree has come, now we are completed, but we are not at the same face, so we will start continuing. So hollow will come here with 120 degree rotation, then inversion, it is solid. Then 120 degree rotation, then inversion, hollow. Then 120 degree rotation, then inversion, solid. We reach to the solid in form of solid, so now rotation is complete. Total again 720 degree we have rotated. Okay. There very interesting image we can see, which says if there is bar 3, then you forget about this part, this hollow. If you see only solid, then these solid are basically 3 fold. And after 3 fold, just plotting after 3 fold, you apply inversion to all the faces. So this will come here, this will come here, this will come here. It means in bar 3, you can do 3 plus I. Okay? But this is not possible in bar 2. If bar 2 is around this, then what will happen? 2 is like this, okay, and then its inversion will be like this. So this is 4-4. If bar 2 is 2 plus I, but in reality, what is bar 2? Bar 2 is rotate 120 degree, then invert, rotate 120, then invert. Only 2 faces, okay. So this is reality of bar 2. And if bar 2 would have been equal to 2 plus I, then this should have been the stereogram. So the point is, only threefold is an operator, bar three is the only operator in which rotation and inversion can be done separately, then also the result will be same. You all to do by yourself while drawing this. If you take one face, rotate 90 degree, it will come here, then invert. Rotate 90 degree, then invert. Rotate 90 degree, then invert. Rotate 90 degree, then invert. You reach to the same position. Again 90 degree operation. So in bar 1, it was 720 degree, bar 3 it was 720 degree to complete one full operation. But in bar 2 it was 360 degree, and in bar 4 again 360 degree rotation required to reach to the same phase or to complete the operation. Means 6 fold rotation, so 60 degree rotation and then inversion. Okay, so 60 degree rotation and then invert it. So here it will as a follow. Okay, 60 degree rotation, then invert, it is solid. Then 60 degree rotation and invert, here it will come as hollow. 60 degree rotation hollow, then here it is solid. In 60 degree rotation solid, here it will come hollow. 60 degree rotation hollow, then here it is solid. So it is done. Okay, bar 6 also in 360 degree rotation we are done. Okay, now this seems like we have one threefold symmetry, because at 120 degree three faces are there, and in the same way three faces are there in the opposite side. So three faces in the northern hemisphere related with threefold symmetry, and three faces in the southern hemisphere related with threefold symmetry, and both of these two faces are related with mirror plane. As you can see, if there is mirror plane, we have seen that if there will be any mirror plane, then any face is like this and mirror plane is along equatorial plane, then it will look like this. The same kind of feature we can see. Okay, so we can say that bar 6 is very similar to a threefold and a perpendicular mirror. See, if you separately do this, let's draw a threefold. Now how will it look like? It will look like 1, 2, 3. This is threefold. Now I say with threefold introduce a mirror plane perpendicular to the C axis. So it will be like this, and now the mirror plane will work and it will create a hollow dot for each solid. So this is the one projection. So bar 6 is similar to three perpendicular mirror plane. So this is how we represent if a mirror plane is perpendicular to a rotational symmetry 3 by m. So let's see other example also. I mean, what is 2 by m, what is 4 by m,
and what is 6 by m.
So it is very clear that 2 by m means a 2-fold symmetry perpendicular to that there will be a mirror plane. 4 by m, a 4-fold symmetry perpendicular to that a mirror plane. Then 6 perpendicular to a mirror plane. Okay. In a stereogram, how the stereogram will look like for these operators? If 2-fold is along C axis, then what will be its stereogram? This is 2-fold. Take any face here, then rotate 120 degree, it will come here, then again 120 degree. So this is 2-fold. Now introduce mirror plane perpendicular to 2-fold. If this is 2-fold, then perpendicular to this means this. So in reality, this 2-fold is along C axis and in a sphere with parallel to the equatorial plane, there is a mirror plane. So the stereogram will look like this, means a solid circle, not the dotted one. Okay. As you insert a mirror plane parallel to the equatorial plane, all face in northern hemisphere will start making it image, its image. So the plane which is in northern hemisphere will create a face in southern hemisphere. So this is the stereogram of 2 by m. Similarly, we can draw for 4 by m. Here it is 4. So draw first for 4-fold. Okay. Now, as you introduce mirror plane, it will create a. So 4 bull size is 4 by m. Okay. Similarly, we can say for the 6 by m, one at 60, 120, then here. So as you introduce mirror plane, full side. Okay, this is 6 by m. But what is common in all these is we have discussed that all these operators means 2, 4 and 6 are along C axis. What if 2-fold is along equatorial plane? Because 4 and 6 cannot be along equatorial plane as we have discussed earlier, because none of the crystal system has such kind of symmetry that 4 or 6 exist perpendicular to C axis. Okay. So if this does not exist, then no need to discuss. But yes, you can think by yourself. If 4-fold is along equatorial plane, then the projection will depend on the real orientation of the starting face. So if 2-fold is here, okay, this is 2-fold. Solid, this will be hollow. This is the 2-fold projection in a stereogram, because if one face is in northern hemisphere and there is 2-fold and rotate it, it will go to the southern hemisphere. But if you project it, then the projection will be at equal distance with 2-fold. So this is how it has been projected. And now introduce a mirror plane perpendicular to 2-fold, means a solid line perpendicular to this dashed line. So this mirror plane means the face present in northern hemisphere will create, see, this is 2-fold, this is 2-fold, and here this mirror plane. So 2-fold has created one face, another face, and mirror plane will create this face as here and this as here. Okay, so 2-fold and mirror plane, one face, another face, mirror plane, one face, another face. Okay, so this mirror plane means this face will make an image with solid and this as hollow. So this is how 2 by m will look like if 2-fold exists along the equatorial plane. So I think with this, this part of lecture is over. So in next video we will be discussing more about the combination of these operators constraining the reality of the crystal, means if we are going to discuss how the stereogram will look like if 2-3-fold exist together, or 2 mirror plane exist together, then what will be the stereogram. But yes, the position of those operator will be according to the crystallography or reality of the crystal. Means in monoclinic system, if you are going to discuss about 2-fold and mirror plane together, then you have to take care about the reality, real situation in which B axis used to be the axis of 2-fold and mirror plane used to be along AC plane. So we will orient those according to that only. This is actually the situation of you can say monoclinic system. B along B axis there is 2-fold, and perpendicular to that along AC there is a mirror plane. There will be a separate lecture series, or maybe we will be informing you all about the numerical aspect of the crystallography, where we will be discussing about the mirror indices and zone axis, how to calculate that, and a lot of numerical on stereogram, and about the forms, numerical on forms, so all possible numerical aspect of the crystallography.